I feel that my talk is some sort of a follow-up of the previous year's dev room. Some were here last year, where we were discussing about community networks and free software. I would like somehow to continue this discussion, and I want to make a very simple argument that imagining and decentralized the internet, I think it makes sense to think of all these nodes of the decentralized internet being grounded, being real spaces in cities, which host servers of distributed services and applications. And this does not come without any cost, so this is what I will try to discuss. I will try to make a small demo to discuss how this can be made possible together with all the other stuff that's going on the internet. So NetHood, that Helekin mentioned before, is a non-profit organization, and we try to bring some sort of diversity in the discussion, and we focus on localities, and we try to combine learning, design, research and action around different type of commoning activities that have all some sort of local element. So to speak, people can come face to face to discuss what their initiatives are doing in terms of housing, complementary currencies, food, community things and technology. And in this context, we work with two European projects on the CAPS framework. That was the first time that somehow these grassroots ideas entered into the European talking. And this project focuses on big community networks like the ones discussed last year, and brings in the issue of diversity, highlighting that all these networks are different, and we need also different ways to approach them and help them flourish. So perhaps you know this is Freifunk. It's a network that it has a viral model and advocates for free access internet to all. It does not depend on funding, but in very clever grassroots and horizontal processes. GWIFI, it's a Catalan network that has a different approach. For them, internet infrastructure is a commons, so they do have some sort of rules, they have governance, and they have achieved to cover a big part of Catalonia with very good internet access for very low price. This is another rural area in my country, in Sarantaporo, that used European funding to build an access network for more than 14 villages for next to Olympus Mountain, which is there. And all these are different, and I try to make a graph. It's wrong. I mean, it's very difficult to classify GWIFI, for example, or Freifunk, since these are more than 100 federated networks. But whoever wants to understand community networks will understand that some are built around local services. So the network creates actually the border of the applications, while others are built to give internet access. Sometimes it happens that also those that are for local services, as the one mentioned above, end up giving internet access because people care just for Facebook. And another important dimension is that some are introvert. The community of the community network is the people that build the network. And in this sense, it could be even seen as a club, because to be part of the builders of the network, you have to put an antenna on your roof. You have to know, I mean, there is an entrance fee, let's say, for this type of communities. On the other hand, there are others that are built exactly to engage people around. And the Pirate Box, perhaps, is you know the Pirate Box. I'm happy it's the first time in my talk I will not have to explain what it's a Raspberry Pi. And so yes, these are the type of small networks that are designed and imagined to operate outside, let's say, the internet. This is from the Occupy movement, and this is an early prototype of the Pirate Box. And this leads me to our second European project that it's called Mazi. Mazi means together in Greek. And our idea in this project is to try this small, let's say, one node community networks with a server on them. Because when I was always discussing about such networks, and the question I was always receiving is why? why somebody would like to communicate only people in proximity. And actually, we try to answer these why questions, trying this type of a local offline, let's say, network in four different communities. One is the Princesin and Garden, and we're very happy that these people, as Helekin said before, do get money for being part of our pilots. We don't just go there and put our technologies. So it's Princesin and Garden in Berlin. There are the young housing cooperatives in Zurich. What you see there is it's called Kalkbreite. It's SPC, it's the neighborhood of one of the first community networks in Europe and in the world. And a nomadic group called An Monastery that works now in rural areas in Greece, like in Sarantaporo and in Ioannina. So, I felt here that it's a good opportunity for me to show things since just giving my talk. You can find online, I have a lot of material. So I will give you a small set demo of the, but now I don't know how to do it with a microphone and I saw, anyway. So, it's worse. It gets me stressed. Okay, I will try. So, this is, I will try to say it very fast. I mean, this is like the pirate box, but with Unohost, let's say. I mean, it's a pirate box that it does not offer you a specific service like file sharing, but offers you a suite of services. Here is a screenshot of an example of the portal with an Etherpad and a Nextcloud, for example, plus a WordPress interface, assuming that this thing would get to the hands of somebody that is not expert. So the idea is to create a WordPress of networks. So as WordPress helps everybody to build their own website, we want to build a WordPress interface that would allow people that can buy such a small server to configure it and offer a local service as they feel it. And so if I, do you see, okay. So I put a password because last time I presented it, somebody hacked it, so. And here is very dangerous. So I will first show the demo and then I will open it for you to play. So the idea is that we offer this standard image as in Pirate Box. Anyway, so yes, and then you have an interface to choose applications, which one of the applications you want to be visible in the portal. The standard was like Etherpad, Nextcloud, Framadate. You can have a WordPress and you can configure the portal page to be the WordPress. This is how it looks, for example. So, whoever connects to this local network, it's been redirected, or I could choose a URL that fits the situation for them to go and use some services that are only local. Yes, this is how. So, for example, if I go here and I go to the Etherpad, when I was playing before, now this goes to the main page. But for example, here I created a page with all the talks, and I could go here to the Etherpad entry and put the URL of my Etherpad that I created. Sorry. Which then if I go to the portal page and click here. Yes. So for example, people that enter in the network without knowing a specific address can be directed to a page where they can do this type of collaborative writing. When I open the password, you can go and write notes for the different things. This is a local service, self-organized, etc. So you understand all these things. I don't want to go into more details. What I will just say is that we have created also some customized apps that we imagine are suitable for such environments, as what we call the guest book. So it's a very simple app that you just add your opinion about a space, an event, and this appears as cards below. Or for example, what we call the internet the interview archive. Sorry. Where, for example, you can add interviews, audio interviews of people in a very simple interface. I was playing now when people were talking. So yes, you don't hear, but so I move now from this. This type of application, for example, was built through a participatory design process in Prinzessin and Garden in Berlin. And the idea is that people there have an urban space where many activists gather, and the people that host them cannot handle all this knowledge that they get access to. So they thought to use this type of small network as a digital overlay of their urban space, where people that visit are being interviewed in a structured way, and all these interviews are uploaded literally on the garden, and people can access to them only when they are there. A big advantage of this type of services that are only accessible on site is that people have to go there. The networks can also break, so we can talk also. It's a more, let's say, hybrid experience. I have a lot to say about this. I mean, this is what I have been talking the last 8 years, but for now I continue. Another pilot that we do is in Zurich in Kraftwerk. Kraftwerk is a very interesting cooperative housing project. Do people know the Bolo Bolo? It was the decentralization of the housing era. So yes, all these cooperative housing projects were inspired by Bolo Bolo, and there is also a new generation that is called Nena. And we try to build such local networks inside these spaces because people are already like-minded and they can understand the values of owning your infrastructure. And here it's not seen very well. We created a photo exhibition in the community space with how this thing began, because many people that live here don't even know that their project has started like this. They went just to get cheap housing. And we try to engage them into a dynamic community art project through this type of local networks. And this brings me to OpenKey, which is a completely different thing that I am engaged the last years. So I don't know, you must have realized also somebody said about diversity and talking to different people. Learning, understanding is perhaps the biggest challenge we have to face. And OpenKey, it's a completely independent project focusing on popular education, on the values of Douay elites and all these people, the idea of creating learning as an everyday activity. And the platform is some sort of a matching service where people can propose courses. This is a proposal, for example. Or really, and after, you can propose different learning topics and people join into your course and you organize. Somebody can provide a space. Somebody can provide an idea. So it's some sort of a collective creation of learning processes. And all these boxes hopefully become real courses with people going to real spaces. And for me, this was a very interesting concept because I imagined, first of all, we need learning and we need to understand how this technology works. But also such a platform could be some sort of aggregator of all these local networks that personally I imagine in this, all these different urban spaces that can somehow expose some sort of their local context on this platform, which gives you some hints of what type of digital activity happens in these spaces, and then you have to go there to participate. Very simply, this guest book that I showed you here, it could be readable. You can see the guest book of the spaces, but you have to go to the space to write to the guest book. It's a very interesting team behind. They are doing very good work with very little resources. And we were all very happy because there is a new project in art space in Zurich called The Church. The artist asks what we do in churches after religion is over. And the answer is we learn things. and Openki now grows into the Zurich space. The idea is to become this type of distributed applications with different, like Mastodon, where you can have in different regions, in different spaces, your own learning platforms that then can share information. And so you have questions? I mean, this is my demo, let's say. I don't know if I could go. I give you 1 minute to think of questions. In the meantime, I change the password here. I put it without password to see if you can. And then I go online to see if I can show you also a demo for Openki. Okay, if you don't have questions, I could go to some more slides that I have about language. Lately, I'm very happy with an analogy that I develop with industrial and organic agriculture. And I think many people have clear feelings about these two images, no? I mean, even people that are not very political or something like that. I mean, our societies feel more good feelings for organic than industrial agriculture. But we have not realized the connection of industrial agriculture and industrial, let's say, digital. And so I try to develop this analogy because I think it's very important to use language that people understand, because it is also a fight of marketing. And maybe we have even signaling someday that in this type of big platforms, there are signs that they may contain algorithmically modified data. And the question is, if this analogy holds, how the organic version of the internet, yes? Yeah. So the question is, if we have organic internet, how we make it work actually over time and correct? Yes. Yes. I mean, it's a process. I don't have the right answer. For me, it's the most important. And in my talks, I always say about complementary things. We don't have to make the whole world being organic. But we need a society options, and we need diversity. And I also call it net diversity, like biodiversity. So the urban gardens will not solve the fooding problem of the world, but they are critical for creating awareness, for bringing people together. So it's not like a big solution for everything. But I think it's very important to have this option, to understand what it means with its problems. The networks I presented here can connect people locally. They will not solve your problem of staying in touch with your child or your mother that lives in another continent. We cannot have single solutions. And the same with blockchain. So yes, I will go just very fast to show that in this tree of social software, we need to build also infrastructure and very importantly have democracy. I want to say this point, that whatever decentralization will do, if we cannot meet in person and decide about things, it will be always one actor, a group of people that will decide for everybody. And the only way to decide together is to meet. And the only way to meet is to have spaces that could host such discussions, and they could be hybrid spaces, both decentralized in the digital and in the physical domain. So yes, this is just an example of this type of spaces that could have their own local networks, which can then connect at regional level with networks like GWIFI or complementary currencies like Sardex. I finished. Thank you. we just created an API that this, sorry, yes, the question is if we try to connect the different spaces where we develop the local networks. And we're creating an API that optionally these local networks could expose some of their data to a server that would be also self-hosted. So it's not an external server, but an internal server. But this is a process. Our focus on this project is what we can do things locally. So we are not in a hurry to connect things because then we lose the locality. At the end, you will need everything. But we want to push a little bit ourselves to the limit of saying, okay, what we can do only here, what an offline network could be useful for and why. So yes, it will be possible soon technically, but it's not our main priority in this project.
When you set up these local networks in the cheap housing communities, how did people end up using them? Did they actively participate in those local networks, or did they use them offline eventually?
Yes, I mean, this is the big question. They don't use. So the question is, sorry, I keep forgetting. The question is if people are using and how they are using them. So right now, the people that use them are our friends. I mean, this idea of connecting to a local network, it's not well understood. So yes, the answer is that it's not. We don't know that these things exist. People don't understand them. They come to us and say, what is this? I mean, how is it possible? I mean, they cannot imagine the idea of a local web service running in the room, and when they leave from the room, they cannot connect anymore. So it's a very challenging communication process, and this is why I think it's important to use the right language. But they are very interested. They are very interested because they understand these analogies, they understand ownership and control, but in terms of use, we are, let's say, in our circles of friends. So, for example, some people upload their photos in this exhibition. We start printing them and change the exhibition according to what people upload. We want to make assemblies to choose photos physically and not just by clicking like. So we are, yes, it's not easy. Yes.